We'll have Elke Orban, Mrs. Elke Orban now. She is the director of the Full Museum in Leipzig and a very dear friend. And it's nice to meet her in Ljubljana. And she'll talk about Teachers Association in Leipzig, which is a big town, about 500,000 inhabitants, and we are looking forward to it.
Thank you very much for introducing. I hope you will understand my bad English. My first language was Russian, you know. In German, in Eastern Germany, we had to learn Russian, and second was French, and third was English. Excuse me, please, my mistakes. My good kind of direction. To the 100th birthday of Heinrich Pestalozzi in January 1846, the Leipzig Teachers Association was founded. Ever since the March Revolution in 1848, the Leipzig Teachers Association, I can say LTA, it's okay? LTA, it's Leipzig Teachers Association, demanded in a certain 10-point program a recreation of the school system. One of their requirements was that all kinds of national education should belong to the government, no longer the church, in 48. 31 founding fathers, you can see here, no, not any mother, are featured in this publication in honor of being 50 years in business, here with Dr. Paul Vogel on the top. As the revolution failed in 1848, the monitoring of the LTA by the police inserted. Instead of discussing school policies, academic circumstances were discussed. Posed by the enormous boom, the industrial boom, you understand, in the 70s of the 19th century, clearly more teachers were needed. From then on, the LTA achieved best practice for school policies and educational work. The LTA struggled for a reformation of religious education, required comprehensive schools, discussed about the right of corporal punishment, reminded of the segregation of church and government, and bothered passionately to enhance the social status of elementary teachers. The LTA also rendered outstanding services for the advancement of educational science and methods. Their own clubhouse, clubhouse, maybe the first in Europe, offered since 1884 a lot of possibilities for convivial gatherings in their restaurant and their bowling alley. To swim against the current was a distinguishing mark of the LTA, and since 1896, the logo of the LTA was upstream, gegen Strom. The Leipzig Teachers Association had 16 departments. I cannot describe all these departments, it's too much. But for instance, this department of arts, or the department of literature, and next department was the library. In 1871, Julius Bieger founded an education main library for Germany and Austria to collect all kinds of literature that belongs to education of children from their very first day of birth to the end of university, to provide any scientist the opportunity to have an orientation of what happened in education in any state at any time, quotation marks. First, by book donations from inland and abroad, also by purchase, the stock of Comenius Association was running high. In 1905, the library moved to another building and evolves in the following year one of the largest education libraries of Europe. You can see the building here. During the Second World War, there was a serious fire and destroyed 340,000 books. only 25,000 books could be saved. Since 1922, the stock is included not in the school museum but in the University of Leipzig. Leipzig teachers newspaper. Of course, this association needs a newspaper, and every month they had a new newspaper for an intellectual and mental center for the teachers of Leipzig. And you can see the name and the face of Ernst Beyer. He was the redactor.
Editor.
Institute of Experimental Education and Psychology. It was also a department of this LTA. To have their own institute, it was a wonderful possibility. The professors are teaching and teacher are researching. From the first beginning, the LTA wanted to combine psychology and education to gain educational scientific findings. A call from Rudolf Schulze in a newspaper did so that the Institute for Experimental Psychology and Education was founded with Dr. Max Brahn. It's not Dr. Max Brahn, here are some pictures from the institute. I show it only and you can think about it. Some experiments with children, sweet, sour, bitter, you can see in the faces of the young girls. Or this picture. I have no time to explain all, but now I have a picture of Dr. Max Brahn, a very important personality. For 20 years he was the leader of this institute, and you can read the biography. It's a pity and it is a shame for us. He couldn't get any professor in Leipzig, and he was murdered in Auschwitz in 1944 because he was Jewish. After the World War, nobody could continue this work, and after 1933, this institute was not closed but was transformed in a Nazi institute. The LTA founded a Museum of Natural Science in this building first and this building second. Maybe we can have this building, I hope so, next year, and transform the school museum in this building. Until now, the Museum of Natural Science of Leipzig is in. Next activity, some pictures from this museum from the 30s. Yes, this LTA published a lot of different books, reading books, many, and song books. And they had also reform classes. In 1911, they had 24 reform classes in 21 schools. You cannot imagine it. So much reform classes, so much parent should be asked. And they had not so much places as wishes to come in. And these pupils learned reading and writing 1 year later, or some month later than usual. In exchange, those classes had optional lessons outside. They learned how to monitor, how to phrase, how to strive to gather for a goal, and learned how to perceive things around in self-motivation with head, heart, and hand, you know, personality. Our children should no longer sit with folded hands on school desk for almost all the time and hear and see and remember. Learning is not teaching them obedience, but teaching them independent thinking, reasoning, and action. Not requirements stimulates them, but assimilation, collaborative action, camaraderie and helpfulness. You understand me, Michael?
Yes.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Thank you. So now we have a big problem. Otto Erler, chair of the methodical department of LTA, polarized between two systems. You can read it: autarky, democracy, capitalism, socialism, learning school, working school, confessional school, secular school. They find it for secular schools. Multiplicity of, I don't know the name for Standesschule, ranking school, yeah, right? Or common school, or standard schools. The conference of directors approved the trial for only 2 years, so that the results didn't provide a realistic picture of performance progress and those experimental class students. But have a look for this wonderful primers. The Primer Commission worked for 2 years on the new primer book in the world. It was, for the first time, it was not so easy to bring it at schools, but after 1 year they had a chance. You have two pictures from it, from 11, and the same book in the world came until 19, after the Second World War once more. The texts were easily to read, and the drawings by Alfred von Münde and Georg Kretschmer elated by their artistic quality and their humor. The didactic, moralized tone of the German imperial era was replaced by modern phrases, but they could also be memorized very easily. This was the danger, it could be very easily memorized. The Latin block letters in the first part of the primer were an achievement of the working school. For the first time, okay, I can see, good. The educators of Leipzig Teachers Association achieved with this primer their latest findings in educational reform. The Lipsian arithmetic books, you can see here some pictures more. During the fascism, the red flag was ausgetauscht, exchanged by a Nazi flag, and after 45 they had the red flag back. It was very easy. So here you can see the rings and the buttons to form the Leo from the book. Yeah, Leo is the one word, the name, and it is from our exposition. So experimental school, I can tell something about experimental school. Here arithmetic books are from Leipzig teachers with Leipzig stories and Leipzig Flughafen here, air traffic from Leipzig. We had it, you can believe we had it, the first of Germany. And now, experimental school. We have a photo from 1916, but the experimental school began in 22. They had their own experimental school in Leipzig. And so they had a chance to bring their pedagogical ideas in this school. No teacher had to give religious information, no religious lessons at school. And this group made, all members of LTA gathered on Sunday from 8 to 11 o'clock a.m., of course. Every member had to choose between the LTA and the public worship, or you can say religious service also. All reform efforts of the LTA culminated in establishing an experimental school. So, But it is too difficult and too long to explain what happens after. I can... Yes, an International Educational Week we had. Mm-hmm. 1 minute, okay. And participants from all over the world, you can see. They came from China, from Germany, from South Africa, from Palestine, from, you can read it here. And 2,000 visitors came to visit Pilgrim to this wonderful school. But after 25, it was very difficult to continue. So they was this LTA was also engaged in your ideas for modern school buildings. There's a school building from 27, very expensive but wonderful. There's three of them in Leipzig, and you can see the furnitures are modern. And here's some pictures from the school, and here from a book you can see a classroom, and here you can see the teacher, the children in this experimental school. Yes, maybe
you leave them there.
I have to finish now. It's a pity because I have some pictures of researching and discovering. It was the idea from the from this LTA, and I would like to show it to you from our museum. You can see discovering and have a game on the floor, and here the Dorfer Reform School. We have an exposition about this LTA in our museum, learning by searching and discovering. It's a principle in our museum. I can only say come and see and discover and research. Thank you for your attention.